Hi there. In this video, I'm going to talk about WordPress hooks, actions, and filters. So to read about them, all you need to do is go to codex.wordpress.org and then type in this URL plugin_API and you'll be taken to this section just below here. So before I take you to the technical aspect of the hooks, let us first understand what a hook or action or filter is. So I have just created a very small diagram for you. So let's say that this is your WordPress installation and your WordPress page is called by the end user or the reader of your blog, and the WordPress is going through a normal flow. For example, it is not using any of the code that you have supplied. But what WordPress has done here is that it has provided the developers with an option to add their own code. So in the process of the normal flow, for example, first rendering the head and then the content and then the footer, it provides certain kind of interventions or certain kind of locations at various points in the WordPress execution where you can add your own code. So if you write your own code right here, and if you hook it to your WordPress blog, then what happens is, instead of going to the normal route, WordPress will take this route, will go through your code, and will resume back to the normal flow. Then while going through the code, it will again find a hook, then it will go to that location and resume from there. So it goes like this rather than going through the normal way, and you can hook your code here or here or here. So basically there are two things you can do. The first is add your own code. For example, your own HTML code to add an image or something like that, or to modify a piece of content like your title of the blog post or the content of the blog post or any other thing that WordPress provides hook for. So there are two kinds of things that you can do. You can use something called as filter and you can use something called as actions. Let me tell you the concept about the filter. For example, let's say your blog post title is my blog post title and your website address is my website. And what you want to do is, instead of just displaying the title, you want to also add, for branding reasons, my website to the end. So in that case, the WordPress comes into your code with this information and you modify this whole thing by adding my website after that and returning this value. So the new title that now comes is my blog post title dash my website, and that is the purpose of the filter. The filter modifies the content or the value that it has been passed to, while action just adds an HTML. For example, you receive an action in header and you want to add a meta tag. So all you need to write is HTML code and that thing will be outputted at the particular location where filter is called. So these are two important ideas of filter and the action. So most common WordPress filters are action and filters are WP head, which outputs a lot of information in the head, and you can attach your function to output information. Then the_content is another very important piece of filter, where you can modify the content of the blog post, and then you have something called as WP title as well. And later on, when you are reaching the end of the document, you can have WP footer as your another action. So some of them are filters and some of them are the actions, and all you can do is to find out what is the filter name and what is the action reference name using the links in here. So if you click on this and this, also on this and this, then you can go to the glossary part where you can understand more about actions, and here if you go you can learn more about filters and all the references to the action, how they work and what are the actions that you can utilize. Plenty of actions, and these this is a very big list. And if you click on plugin API filter reference, you will be taken to all the filters and you can modify the values provided by them. Let me take a very basic example of WordPress filter. So for example, this is our blog post. This is our blog with a number of blog posts. And if we just hover on the top here, you can see that there is a title that pops out, which is just another WordPress site. All I'm going to add is some kind of string to this title and check out whether this thing really works. To see the title in its completeness, all you need to do is right click on this and go to view page source, and then from here you search for the title tag. So as you can see, the title and the slash title tags have the title in between, and we are going to add some kind of string to the end of this title. Now we open the project in our local file folder. If it is your hosted site, that's also fine. The structure will remain the same, and the theme folder located inside the WP content folder contains the theme called as 2014, which is the current theme that you see here in this blog post. And I'm going to modify and I'm going to modify functions.php file of that theme. So functions.php will be available in almost all the themes. It's a requirement, and you can write your custom code here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the title of the whole blog post just by adding some kind of string to that. I'll use this function called as add filter, and the filter that is used to change the title of the blog post is WP underscore title, and I will give it some kind of function here, for example my function, and I would close this. Now I have to define the contents of the my function, so I'll define that, create a body. The thing about filters is that they have a parameter. So for example, the WP title filter will pass me a parameter which will be the title of the blog or the blog post. So it would be an argument to this function. I'll call it dollar title, and what I'm going to do is create a new string and give it some value like my blog. Then I'm going to return this value with the title, and it is appended by dollar string. So now when I run this code, the filter will be added to WP title, and this function will be called. This function will take a parameter called as dollar title, and I'm going to add some kind of a string. I'll just put a dash here so that makes more clear. And when I go to my blog post, I'll just hit F5 to check out whether this is happening like that or not. So I can't tell from here. I'll have to go to the source code and refresh it. So as you can see, now the title has changed. The title has been appended with my blog. So the original title remains, but my function has added some kind of information to it. This title is very useful when you want to, for example, make certain kind of keywords available in your Google search. So if I type TV, and I can see that the title is displayed by your by the search engine, for example Google or Bing, and it is taken from the title tag. So sometimes it is very useful. For example, they have added tv.com in front rather than at the back, so you can also do that. All you need to do is reverse this thing, remove the dollar string from here. Save it and refresh the source code once again. So as you can see, my blog has been prepended to this title rather than, you know, going at the end. It all depends on your advertising and your marketing strategy. If you want to show your name of website or certain specific keyword right in the before the title, you can do it like that. So this explains the part of the video where filters are used to modify certain kind of details. So you have this list which you can use. You can just go through this list, and there are plenty of filters which you can utilize to modify your WordPress blog. So this is just a starting point and not the end of it. You will have to go through each of it to understand what each filter does for you. Now in the next part, I'm going to talk about actions. So as you can see from this screen, there are plenty of actions, and there are some important actions that are used very commonly. So one of it is WP footer. What it does is to add some kind of HTML code to WP to the footer section of the blog post. So for example, if we have this blog post here, and if you want to add something like copyright or, you know, things like that, we can do that. Now adding of action is much simpler than the filter. All you need to do is add underscore action and take the action name, which is WP footer, and give a function, for example my underscore in two double quotes, in two single quotes, my underscore action semicolon, and then you can go for function my underscore action. Action may or may not involve any kind of parameters, but mostly you can leave it blank. And here what you're going to do is you're going to add some HTML. So I'm just closing the PHP tags so that I can write some kind of HTML, and I will write here P powered by my blog. So when I run this, this code would be added to the footer section of the blog. I have just refreshed it for you, and as you can see, if the theme implements WP underscore footer hook or the action, it is stored here, and you can modify and add HTML right here. So this powered by my blog was outputted by the function, and there was nothing needed to modify or change, hence we were able to add the HTML. So I guess the difference between the filter and action are much clearer now. So I hope you enjoyed watching my video. If you have any questions, do let me know by commenting or sending a message. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.